It's 12 o'clock on a Monday. I'm Blaze.
I'm Juliana. This is Zhao Yu.
What up, everyone?
And welcome to
Rave Train. Woo! Woo!
In news this week, we are talking about boom boom energy.
Yeah, this is what I got right here. What is this?
It's kind of interesting. So we all know us old school ravers remember Vicks. This is sort of like Vicks 2.0, essential oils.
Yeah, it's got like peppermint, vitamins. Eucalyptus.
Yeah.
Woo! I feel good to go.
Yeah, well, I've always loved how part of rave culture, at least when I started, these people would just kind of randomly come up to you and be like, hey, can I help you? And I'd be like, why are you helping me? They'd spray you with water, fan you. And they would give you like a Vicks shoddy or something like that.
Yeah,
and I always
like
loved that.
On your face, and it's just like when you're so hot and you're sweating profusely, and they come by with this like menthol air on your face. Oh, such a relief.
Yeah, I just always loved that idea of like the magical rave fairy, and I love that this culture is still going and growing. And actually, this is a healthy product for you as opposed to something like Vicks, which is gonna basically
kill you.
It's all
natural.
Yeah.
So cool.
So yeah, so check it out. This boom boom energy.
I like it. On this week's episode, we have some dancers from Amazing Orbital, and we got DJ Jounce on the decks.
And now it's time for Zhao Yu's Pearl of Wisdom.
Constipated raver, don't give no shit.
Ooh. Zhao Yu, press play.
This week with
DJ Jounce.
DJ Jounce, nice to have you on the show.
Thanks for having me on the program.
Oh, we're so happy to have you here. So tell me, what are you going to be playing for us?
I do mostly electro house and progressive house. I'm going to start off nice and easy, where we're going to keep the vibe up and get it going.
Okay, I'm excited. Take it away.
Thank you.
No.
see, I'm all the way.
Yeah.
you know she drunk. I'm here for one night, so I ain't going home. Unless I'm living here with you, then you never saw. Surrounded by some tricks and a couple freaks. Baby, bitch, your face is a trace of weed. Check it, I got both, so that's all we need. The club closed at 3 and I ain't trying to leave.
And that's our show for the week.
Tune in next time.
We'll catch you at the after party.
Yo, what's up, guys? It's Johnny Blaze, and this is my rant. This is the part of the show where we talk about controversial issues or just things that a lot of people want to talk about, or whatever I want to talk about. And this week, we're talking about something awesome. We're talking about candy. Yes, candy, which I don't actually have on right now, is something amazing that's part of the rave community. And along with candy, as we all know, people plur. Peace, love, unity, respect. And this is sort of the raver motto, and kind of what we stand for and what we believe in. And as far as I know, historically, where candy comes from, it was when you went to festivals early on in the days, you would make candy, and if you met somebody special or you met somebody that you had a bond with, you would play with them and exchange it, and then you could use that piece of candy to remember the moment and remember the person and have a nice thing that you guys can share together. And the more festivals you go to, the more candy that you collect, the bigger your friendships become, the bigger the candy becomes, and to me, that is what candy represents. And for a while, candy was banned, and now it's back, and some festivals don't want candy. They don't know what it is. It's definitely a very specific sort of Southern California cultural phenomenon. We don't see candy in European festivals. We don't see even candy in New York festivals sometimes. But I love it. I think it's amazing. I think we need candy every day, people wearing it all the time, but keeping it rave, not making it some like dorky mainstream thing that you could buy candy from a website online. You should be making your own. But I want to hear your thoughts. What are your thoughts on candy? You guys love it? Is it stupid? Is it silly? Is it goofy? Is it magical? What's the best candy you got? So many funny stories I can think of right now. Just thinking in my head, amazing moments, getting candy. So hit me up, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook Live. I want to hear your thoughts. Candy, kids, let me know. What's up? Cheers. We'll be right back.